M-I-L-K.
Are you turning into a superhero?
M-I-L-K.
It's supercharging his hearing now.
M-I-L-K.
On the average night, three nuts.
M-I-L-K. Skin like a lag.
He's got porn fingers.
M-I-L-K.
A beautiful mind.
M-I-L-K.
Superbo.
M-I-L-K.
This is one of those shows, man.
M-I-L-K. Skin like a lag.
Damaged goods starts now.
Brain damage.
In a world where the blind lead the blind, three men brought together by the primal urge for domination and the thirst to insult your intelligence. Fireball Jesus, Sith Lord, the Golden God, the Holy Trinity of Entertainment. These men are out of patience, and you are out of time. You're listening to The Damaged Goods Show.
Yes. Hey, where are the white women at?
Ah, damaged goods. They're on your phone. They're falling out of your phone.
Yeah. You got right.
I love the pre-show porn. And I can only hear it. I can't even see it. Yeah. I just hear it.
You hear it? Yeah. What'd you hear?
Do you want me to mimic what I heard? It's going to be pretty embarrassing for all of us.
Yeah, see, I can never fucking catch you on no bullshit.
No, you can't, bro. Oh, he's on my game. Yeah, he's always I'm the golden guy.
Always on bullshit, man.
My bullshit.
Yeah.
That's all this is bullshit. Your character in my mind, we went over this.
Yeah, we did. Yeah.
Isn't that trippy?
Yeah, he doesn't, none of you guys exist.
Like I'm a character in his mind.
Mm. Yeah. Right. I created you in my mind, and you're here, and we're doing this in time and space, and it means nothing.
Yeah.
You thought you were important before.
Right.
You were a person.
Yeah.
But that was nothing. Because now the real important thing is that you're a character in his mind.
That's it.
Which is more important
that
than
being a
real
person.
That
does make me pretty important.
It does.
You stepped into the holy trinity of entertainment. Yes, you have. Very special night tonight.
Oh, yeah.
Friday evening. Friday. I'm feeling it tonight, people. You're in for a fucking beating. All of you. Every one of you.
Okay.
Yes. Well, I mean, I don't even know where to begin. But I guess I got to start by introducing the fucking panel.
The panel, folks.
The panel. To my left, the Sith Lord.
What's up, fuckers?
Sith motherfucking Lord.
What's going on?
How you be?
Yeah, I had a rough day, but I'm here, man.
Yeah. You've had a rough week.
Yeah.
Losing quite a bit this week.
Yeah.
Lost a few times.
Yeah. Sounds like you've had a rough life.
I've been taking a couple L's lately.
Yeah, ugh.
Wow. Yeah, no one can keep the Sith Lord down.
Your Vikings, your betting habits, celebrities that are going to die in jail.
Oh, God. Come on, bro. You just want to just come on right at it right now.
Not yet, because I still have to introduce Fireball fucking Jesus.
Yo.
There it is.
What's happening? Good to be here. No, just kidding.
Good to have you back.
Oh, thanks.
Yes. I don't know how long this will last, but, you know.
Look, I'm trying. You know, I'm trying to be a good person and do my best and be upstanding and do this show and give the public what they want, information from Damaged Goods. So
you are the minister of information here at Damaged Goods.
That's right.
Baghdad Bob, we'll call you.
Oh,
line up children.
That's the best fucking nickname I've ever had. It usually has something to do with ass and rape, so I feel pretty good about that one. Baghdad Bob it is.
Also joining us tonight, the one and only friend of the show and probably the most famous person I know, Andre McSween.
Damn, that's a damn shame. What up, bitches?
Welcome back, my man.
Oh, man, thank you for having me, man.
Pleasure on this side of the table.
The pleasure is all mine.
Very nice.
Yeah.
How you
all
been,
the ways
bro?
From Brooklyn.
Yeah, that's right. Down here from Brooklyn. In the fucking forest, the woods in New Jersey.
That's right.
I'm good, man. I'm good. Just got married.
Nice.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
I mean, congratulations.
I know. I'm not an eligible bachelor anymore. I'm married.
How long did you know her? I have to know.
It'll be 2 years In a couple of weeks.
And you still liked her enough to marry her after 2 years?
No yeah, way. Man.
That never happens. Yeah. Good
bro,
for you.
We went on our first date, and I spoke to my little brother that night. He's like, oh, how'd that date go? And I said, I think I met the girl that I'm going to marry.
Oh, romantic. Oh,
yes.
Holy shit. Wow.
Love
we
her.
Know all about yeah. romance here.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Yeah, I can tell.
Yeah, right. There's a couple of women. Locker room down here. Yeah, it's all about romance.
Yeah.
Holy chains shit. And handcuffs, a little bit of blood splatter on the wall. Romance.
Oh, yeah.
That's how we do it.
We got to pay dividends. I should have said pay dues. Anyway, man, sorry about your week, dude.
Yeah, it's all right, man.
Bill Cosby's dying in jail.
They asked for it!
No, he's not, motherfucker. Let me tell you something. Bill Cosby right now talking to his lawyers. You already know what he's doing, right? You heard what he's doing right now, right?
No.
He's suing the bitch. The first bitch. He's suing her for all the money he gave her.
Yeah, well, he's dying. Okay. Broke yeah, that
have
out,
fun.
Right? Pile of money.
Well, he's going
to
sue
her all the money he gave her.
Yeah. How's he going to win?
She saw the chocolate cake.
Hello? If he's paying fucking money already to stay out of jail from one bitch, and she fucking testified against him anyway, and he already had... paying her to not testify or do nothing, he's gonna get his money back.
Okay. All right. Great. Spend the money in jail.
I heard he got. Damn, man.
So raped already?
Yeah,
wow.
I heard
that was
he's in protective custody. Bill Cosby is not in population.
Somebody threw a hot dog bun at him, yo.
He was probably behind like five gates and shit. That hot dog bun, not even a crumb touched him.
Chucked it up in the fence.
That's the worst thing that can happen to Bill Cosby in jail if somebody throws a hot dog bun at him.
Get your hot dogs here.
Now if they start throwing their hot dogs at him, he got a problem. And they put it in his buns.
Oh, ooh.
Listen. 6 months.
6 months? Nah, I don't know.
No fucking way. Minimum 3 years, dude. Yeah. He's blind. He's frail. He's dying in jail.
6 months.
And they're serving him.
He's old. He could be gone tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
He can never even make it in.
Six months.
Oh, he's an old man. How old is Bill Cosby?
81.
Yeah.
He's 81.
He's
going to
die
old.
In prison.
No, he's not.
Where's he gonna be?
When are you ever gonna admit defeat? Just fucking say I lost. We're even.
He has
white black bet is back at zero. We are neutral. Let's just do it. He's gonna die.
And he's lived a full life.
If he doesn't, I'm gonna fucking fly out to Pennsylvania and kill him my fucking self.
Right,
and
right.
I'm gonna win.
That's where he's serving his sentence.
Yeah, yeah. He's in a
that's
brand
how I
new
know he's
prison.
Not gonna do his shit. He's not gonna do fucking time out there. It's in PA.
He's
gonna
do like
that's where
3 years.
But listen, bro, I'm trying to tell you.
I know what's gonna happen.
It's gonna
I'll
do
tell you what's
six
gonna happen.
Months.
6 months on a 3 to
10.
So
now we have to kick the bet down the road six no. more months.
All right. On a 3 to 10. All right.
3 to 10.
One. He gonna do 1 year, good behavior,
he's
house arrest or some bullshit like that. He's not doing 3 fucking years.
Look, even if he does,
he'll do one
3 year.
Years.
He'll live 3 years because he'll be catered to.
Oh, he's
jail.
Gonna be the man. He's
and then
the man.
He'll get out and be free and be. Vindicated
Listen,
or whatever, but he'll live out the rest of his life for another probably 20 years because he's got so much fucking money and shit.
Let me tell you something. Those COs, they pay just got doubled. And that's on some real shit.
Yeah.
If they was making $1,200 a week, guess what, bitch? You making $24 now.
Fuck yeah.
Your shit just upped. You right. taking care of
them. He ain't no regular motherfucker.
Hell no, he ain't.
I have a question. Yeah. How do you feel about that, Andre? Like, you're black.
Yeah.
Sith is black, not trying to separate us here, just pointing out. He seems to be a fan of Cosby, right? In
I'm
a certain
a fan
way.
Of Cosby.
Like you want
him
to get
yeah.
out, you're rooting for him.
Fat Albert, right? That's what did it.
Well, no,
how do you
listen,
feel
no,
about
no, wait, oh. man, I don't want him. Hold up. I'm not saying what he did was right, okay?
But the bitches deserved it.
It's my barbecue sauce.
You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying what he did was right. Because he could have, you know what I'm saying? He could have did the old school.
He could have killed him,
no,
but he didn't. He
no,
was a nice guy.
He could have did the old school rape and just raped him.
People have some of my barbecue sauce. After a while, when it kicks in, they get all huggy buggy.
You know what I'm saying?
The old school rape.
Kept them a week, you know.
Yeah.
Let them experience.
I'm saying.
A few punches.
Do the old school. Listen.
Gut punches.
My barbecue sauce. I'm dead serious.
Do a couple donkey fucking punches, you know. You know what I'm saying? Do a couple Bloody Marys, you know.
I got a cup of it. Up on the night table.
Strawberry shortcakes. You know, but listen.
Get your little Debbie's.
Jell-O pudding pops. Chocolate cake.
My barbecue sauce.
He could have did the old school rape. You know what I'm saying? And he probably would have.
No, I don't.
No, what the fuck you mean you don't? He could.
I've never done an old school rape.
Well, listen, will you?
I hope not.
Explain.
I hope he didn't even do a new school rape.
What? There you go. That's what he did. He did the new school rape.
Right.
He was the inventor of the new school rape.
You know anything about Spanish fly?
This motherfucker.
Yes, he was.
And then he talked about
pioneer.
It in his act.
Absolutely.
Pioneer. Am
Absolutely.
I right or wrong? This motherfucker got right. drugs, bro, and he got these women bombed out of their fucking mind.
You put some in her drink, man. She.
These bitches already wanted to fuck him, but he took it to another fucking level. He probably wanted to fuck him in the ass and fuck him in the mouth.
Chocolate cake coming up.
Whatever they didn't want him to, didn't want him to
he
do.
He was tired of asking.
He
just
exactly.
drug him up and take what you want.
Damn
and
right.
And
he
kick
took
him
the,
out of the hotel.
When he took those Quaaludes, Joe, it was a wrap.
They asked for it.
When he fucking admitted it, okay, all right. Well,
so he's
guilty.
A hero of yours. We get it, Sith, but
he's not a hero.
He called him a pioneer.
Spanish fly, Spanish fly. This is the land of Spanish fly.
He called him a pioneer.
I don't know, man. I don't know.
I'm just saying, niggas do it now, though. Say niggas ain't doing
and they
it
fucked
now.
Up too.
It's referred to as you just got Cosby'd.
Yeah, you know, I don't know, man. I feel like if he is guilty, then he needs to go and serve his sentence, and mm-hmm. that's it. Mm-hmm. If he's guilty, I wasn't there. I don't know. You know,
and you didn't listen
up.
To any of the testimony.
I don't know.
Like, I didn't either, but
I don't know. I didn't even pay attention to any of the court shit that was on TV. I didn't pay attention to any of that.
Do you feel in any way compelled to like back him up because he's one of the first black super entertainers?
No,
people?
No,
fuck
no,
that.
Not at all.
And you're
not
in comedy.
No.
But you know what? Because I got a daughter, you know what I mean? And
exactly.
I got a mother, okay. You know what I mean?
Always gets the green light from mom because it's so rich and creamy.
So, like, I don't feel like I have to back him up. Cause, all right, okay, he is one of the first black super entertainers. But I feel like, you know, they talk about equality, right? If you want equality, then all rapists should be treated equally. And
right.
if you did that shit, then you need to serve your time. You need to go and go where rapists go
right.
and be treated the way rapists
he
treated.
Needs some street cred. Is that what you're saying?
No.
He needs some street cred, then he can come back out on the streets and get a whole new gangster type
nope.
show.
Nope.
He ain't coming back out on
Cosby.
Any streets.
In a
he
hearse.
Is, he is 81 years old.
The reason why
and,
they
well,
want...
he could prank bitches and rape them no, like on a reality type show.
I'm not doing that anymore.
The reason why they want to fry
like
Bill.
It.
The reason why they want to fry Bill is because Bill was drugging white fucking bitches. Okay, nigga, you want some white pussy? All right, well, you cool. You in Hollywood. You fucking white bitches. But, nigga, you going to drug them now? You drugging bitches now? No. And then raping them? Oh, you got to go.
I don't think that's the case. Because I think
oh, hell yeah.
No, because it was so long ago. The
statute
exactly. of limitations
that's even worse.
Ran out. They were willing to look the other way. You don't think they've ever heard these allegations before?
There were just so many.
Yeah. To quote Jim Norton, comic, he said, okay, Cosby's accused of raping 30 women. Say half of them are lying. He still raped 15 women.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He raped one. Even one.
Right.
That's hardly
saying,
anything.
Like,
you're right. He's practically innocent at that point.
Right.
I agree.
It's only 15.
Jesus Christ.
I don't know where the fuck this is going.
Fireball Jesus.
Fireball Jesus.
All I'm saying is
Fireball right. Jesus Christ.
Damn.
Cobbs is going to do 1 year. He's going to be out on house arrest. He's going to be
no.
back in his fucking mansion.
Is this another bet?
I yes. think he's going to get out of jail, and maybe he'll do 3 years, maybe, but he'll still be alive.
Oh, nah, man, no yeah. fucking maybe.
He'll live
to
95 years
man?
Old,
what,
dude.
Is he doing 3 years or not, man?
He might do 3 years.
No, you
say
he might,
I say 2 years. He's going to do
he
a minimum
a
of 2 years.
Definite number.
He's going to do a minimum of 2 years, and then he's going to serve some, like, time at home or some shit. And he'll probably be on probation for the rest of his life because he's
right.
81, you know? He's probably got seven more fucking years.
He's not a harm to the community.
Yeah. He's not. He's really not, man.
Yeah, yeah. You want to bet?
My barbecue sauce.
Watch.
And I'm not trying to downplay what he did
right.
at all.
You're sticking up for him because he's black.
I'm
just
not sticking
it.
Up for him
admit
because
it.
He's black. I do. I love Bill Cosby, man. I love Bill Cosby. It was one of the first impressions that I ever did. But if he raped.
Oh. What? I thought you were going to keep going.
No,
do a Jell-O pudding commercial.
No.
Bill Cosby showdown between Richard Lee and Andre. I see it later in the show.
But yeah, man, definitely. If he serve your time, Bill.
Well,
that's right.
I'm done with it.
Find Suge, man. He's in
you
there.
Guys, you guys are wrong.
Yeah.
Why? How are we wrong?
Not doing more like than 1 year, man.
Okay, so then could we just close this off and say that we're even now? If you want to get another bet.
Yeah, we're even, but okay. I'll still bet you.
Yeah, okay, so now we'll start another one.
Yeah.
So we're even, 0-0.
I got another. Now, I got two more bets for you.
Okay, cool.
Whoa,
I like it. It's got to be race bait, right? It's got to be race bait bets.
Okay.
Okay. So the first, racist. I'm still going to say Cosby dies in jail. You say he's doing a year.
Yeah. He's
okay.
Not, he's just
that's
doing
the
a
new
year.
Bet, but we're even. So when he dies in 4 years in prison, I win.
Yeah, okay. You made me laugh. Thank you.
Yeah. He's like he's supposed. This guy thinks he's gonna fucking deteriorate as soon as he hits
I don't
the
think
fucking,
so. Yeah.
The four walls, but he's supposed to just fucking melt.
I think he got this one. Seth.
I think he's gonna be put in Gen Pop pretty soon.
He is not gonna be put in Gen Pop.
Are you kidding me?
No way.
Hell no.
He's going to Gen Pop.
No way.
Smaller people have not been put in Gen Pop. They're not going
to
put
Bill
Cosby in Gen Pop.
The Golden God has ordered him to Gen Pop.
He's going to get the softest mattress.
Hell
he's going to
yeah.
get almond milk. Okay? He's going to get vitamins and shit.
Spanish fly.
Okay.
Food's going to be brought to him.
Chocolate cake coming up.
Literally. It's not what I read. I've already done my reading. It is written. It was written.
Did you see how OJ was treated?
Yeah, I lost that bet, remember? Yeah. I said he was going to die in jail, too, and that was the first bet I lost.
Okay, but did you see how they was treating him? See how those COs was treating him? You see how they was fucking feeding and eating off of him? He's a little millionaire. Bill Cosby is heavyweight,
he's a godfather.
Bro. He's going to have fucking filet mignon in there.
Cosby has nothing left. How much is his net worth?
What? What do you mean? Cosby ain't got nothing left. Are you
he
fucking
has,
what?
He has the drive to be like, fuck you to everybody. To
yo, Cosby ain't broke,
that's
bro. He's still living
that's
off of Fat Albert money, man.
Hey, hey, hey. It's Fat Albert.
But where's Fat Albert now? No one sees Fat Albert anymore. It's not on.
And I'm going to sing a song for you.
Too racist. It can't
yeah.
be.
Yeah.
Bill's going to show you a thing or two.
Still living off that money,
and
man.
And the Cosby Show got yanked out of circulation, too. I mean, your boy was fucking working at Trader Joe's. That's how we fucking closed this off, too, by the way.
Yeah, he was.
Fucking, what's his name? Jeffrey Owens was his name.
Yeah, you know, Nicki Jeffrey Minaj Owens. Gave that faggot fucking $25,000 fucking dollars. You know what he did with it?
Gave it away. That's right.
To who?
To a fucking charity. Donation charity.
His net worth is estimated at $400 million.
A mirror bag of shells.
Yeah. That guy ain't staying in there.
400 million. That's a lot of money.
That's like El Chapo.
For the sentence he's serving, that's a lot of money.
That's $500 million.
That's like El Chapo.
He's gonna. Yeah.
How long did El Chapo
that's a
stay
lot,
in there?
That's a lot of Hot Pockets.
And Cheetos.
It is.
And pocket pussies.
Some warm suit of sheets.
He can hire people to dig a hole out of prison and get him out of there
if he wanted to.
Just like El Chapo.
I'm going to even break it down into two words. If he wanted to, he can get every CEO fired in that fucking prison and have his own CEOs come up in that bitch.
He could buy the prison. He could buy the prison.
Him and Michael Jordan.
Oh, Michael Jordan.
Just fucking buy the motherfucking prison.
Oh, y'all gonna put me in the
pronounce
pudding.
Himself king and that's it.
Oh, wait, another impression just showed up. Another Cosby impression.
Oh, no, I don't know how to do Cosby.
You just did it.
No, well, I'm not.
Oh, I wish we had separate tracks. I'd go back and grab that one. He actually did a pudding one.
Oh, really? Come on, Seth.
I'm putting my dick in your mouth.
We had a ball.
I'm putting my dick where it don't belong.
I just hope Bill has a short time stay. I would have hoped they would have caught him doing this shit earlier. So then he could have had a longer stint. You know what I'm saying? But being that he's 81.
You sound real broken up over it.
No, listen. Being that he's 81, he doesn't care.
Right.
He made his money. You know
I think
saying?
He does care.
Oh, only thing is hurting right now is his pride.
His
pride
reputation
is destroyed.
Fucked anyway.
Yeah.
It's fucked
but,
anyway.
But listen.
There's no coming back
but,
from
but
it.
As you just read. His bank account is still there.
Yeah, still.
And when he steps
just don't know
out,
I just don't know how. Where's the money coming
but,
from?
But listen,
now? It's like, so what is his net worth?
When he steps out of that jail, he's Bill Cosby. Okay,
he's getting he's picked up in a Rolls
he's starting
Royce
exactly
on his last.
And think he's starting exactly from where he stepped off at. You know what I'm saying? And he probably
well,
got a couple. He probably got like five more white bitches waiting for him as soon as he get home.
I don't know about that.
Man, it's fucking dream.
Oh, Bill,
spinning.
Rape us. Yeah. We've been waiting for you.
They're waiting outside with signs.
I'm just telling you, man.
I'm not doing that anymore.
I don't know about that.
Man, listen. Once a rapist, always a rapist.
Oh, jeez.
You would know, Seth.
Right,
you would know.
pretty I'm transparent just, what's going on around here.
I'm just saying, once a rapist, always a rapist. No. I don't think he still, you know.
No matter how much therapy
he's got, he's worth $400 million. You think he's not going to keep his yang working?
Yeah, man, you can keep your yang working, but you don't need rape to do it. I don't, well, I think that there's a such thing as people changing, you know, like.
He's 81 years
okay.
old. When the fuck is he gonna change?
Come I'm on. Glad he said people can change.
They can.
Okay. So what the fuck is wrong with R. Kelly?
Maybe it's just not his time to change,
yeah,
right?
No,
now.
He's
been doing it for 20 years.
So what? Cosby had a beat for a long time. But see, R. Kelly's
been doing it for 30, 40 years.
Yeah, he's got him beat. He's buried him.
And not everybody's going to change. OG. Not everybody's going to change.
See, but R. Kelly's doing it, like, you know, subliminally.
No,
right?
He's not. Not no more.
Listen, how he's smacking bitches around and drugging them?
R. Kelly, he's kidnapping bitches. What the fuck are you
He needs them all. Every last one.
He's
your body's calling.
Bitches. He's keeping them in the house and they're not allowed to leave.
I feel like I need to read more about this kind of shit because you know I look at R. Kelly and
I
say, oh, R. Kelly, they trying to tear R. Kelly down because he likes young girls. What about fucking Hugh Hefner? Hugh Hefner.
Yep, I've been saying
Hugh
that.
Hugh Hefner
I say
is
that?
Fucking with 18-year-olds and 19-year-olds.
Worse
all
than
the
that.
Time.
Hey, that don't make him a bad person.
It doesn't make him a bad person.
No, it doesn't.
But why does it make R. Kelly a bad person?
Because Hugh's
not.
Not
saying that he's not a bad person. I'm not trying to say that what he did wasn't bad.
I can tell you the difference. Hugh Hefner is just as much as a pedophile as R. Kelly. And I told you guys this before. Don't forget about when Hugh Hefner took Brooke Shields when she was 11 years old and put her in her fucking magazine.
Right, okay.
And she was spread eagle with her fucking cooch out and everything.
At 11 years old?
11 years
you
old.
You can pull that shit up right now if you want.
I don't know. I don't want to. I'm sorry.
And then the FBI will break in and shoot you in the forehead.
You, hands in the air.
Well, listen.
Was she 11?
She was 11 years
There's
old.
There's no fucking way she was 11 years
yeah,
old.
She was 11 years old, bro.
All right.
And Andre's
looking it
hold
up.
Up.
Someone
but
track his
why,
IP address.
But that's why when she, that's why when, don't you remember when we were younger? Brooke Shields. Everybody was like, Brooke Shields. By the time we got there, she was like 18 in her.
I'm calling
in
bullshit on this story. You said she was 11 and had full bush. What 11-year-old has full bush?
Right.
What?
This is fake news.
I didn't have a full bush till I was 22.
Yeah. Get the fuck out of here. You got, well, I don't
she
know what
posed,
to tell you.
Let me see. Brooke Shields, Playboy, she posed when she was 10 years old. I see she Whoa. Posed when she was 10.
Hit image. Hit Whoa. Image. You
no,
know,
don't
pull
hit
it
image.
Up.
Don't hit image.
We mean it's in Playboy,
why
bro.
Why a
10-year-old
Brooke Shields posed nude?
It's wow, Sith yes. Lord.
He knows
Respect.
It all. When it comes to porn, porn king, ladies and gentlemen.
Naked bitches, his specialty.
Yes.
That's crazy.
He's got porn fingers.
That's crazy.
That?
But nobody is trying to demonize Hugh Hefner.
Well, he's
not.
Oh,
yeah. I
well,
think a lot
did.
Of people hated
they
him.
They did before he died. They were like, you know, oh, don't praise him because mm-hmm. he, 'cause of that. But he's the same thing as R. Kelly.
The
R.
magazine
R. Kelly,
goes on, though, right?
The magazine boomed.
Right.
Hugh Hefner it has boomed. Music that's better, I think, though. I hate R. Kelly's music.
Well, I have to say this. I think they're both shitty for what they've done.
Of course.
They're both
softer,
shitty.
Softer, gentler side of Andre McSween, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm grown now. I'm grown.
I see that.
Grown.
He has his head on straight.
You're in good shape, my man. You work out hard.
He just got married. His wife told him how to feel, and he's feeling real sentimental.
No, I've always
pro women's rights. All
I'm all about. I was raised by a house full of women. You know what I mean? So like, I'm all about
browbeating. Yes,
no,
broken.
What's right?
Wait,
and that's gross, man. You took a 10-year-old girl and put her to pose in your magazine. She's 10 years old.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Why like let's think about what 10 years old means. Like 10 years
that's
old.
That's fucked.
What's that? That's like fifth grade.
Yeah.
And for what I remember in the pictures, they made it seem like it was like no.
Why do we think
you studied series? Those pictures?
Fuck
I know
you, Fireball. I haven't seen them. What the fuck you mean? What do you just 11. Can't just go by he, she, say and all that. You have to see the evidence. And I went and I looked and I seen the pictures. All right? And from what I've seen
it's
in the
CSI
pictures.
CSI over here, this
oh,
guy.
God damn
evidence.
You.
It's
I've
called
seen,
evidence.
They, it wasn't like, you know, it wasn't like Skank Magazine where the bitch had her legs and her fucking twat spread open, holding lips. No, it wasn't like that. They made it seem like on a modeling type, you know what I'm saying, sensual side, like she was modeling.
It's an artistic.
But, right.
It's art.
But.
Pedophilia.
There's a difference.
She was still fucking butt-ass fucking naked. And
And so where was the outrage at the time? Like, I don't think that's ever
I'm glad you asked that. I mean, at the time.
Yeah, that's not good.
Was that okay?
It's not good. It's never good.
Right.
See, at the time it happened, it was during the 70s. And as you guys know, during the 70s, they were on that fucking hippie shit, just coming out of that hippie shit. Right. And they were on to that free...
disco.
You know, yeah, free love and drugs.
Right.
So,
I think the 60s was more free love and drugs.
70s. Yeah, but the 70s, cocaine, doing the disco cocaine hits and in shit. 70s, man.
But I don't think it was ever like free love, drugs, and like...
Pedophilia.
Yeah. Exactly. It's like, no, I don't think
it
that...
was.
Pedophilia wasn't like really adopted until now when they're trying to actually
Some
make that...
Some people took it too far.
Right? Aren't they trying to make that like one of the, you know, like the LGBTQ and then something for pederasses?
Yep.
Right, that's fucked up.
That's like,
why is that now accepted?
It's
because
gonna happen.
We live
day.
In a strange
it's
world
happen,
right now, man. We live in a strange world where
it's
everybody
is fucked up.
It's like
piece
every
of shit.
It's like they're trying to be sensitive to everybody and their needs and who they
you
are.
Can't
and it's
operate
like
that. It's
yeah, what are you
Some
gonna
shit's
do?
Not okay. People need to get punched in the head or slapped around, or like stop acting like a fucking asshole. And so you snap back into it. But
there's certain shit that's just not normal.
I just want to say this. One of my first porns that I ever watched
was Brooke Shields.
No.
Oh.
It was no. It
but
was
you
called,
were 10, so it was fine. I got you.
Hey. You gotta do what you gotta do. It was called Taboo.
Okay.
Taboo 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay.
Watch the whole fucking series.
I binge watched.
Listen.
I was 3.
It was the 70s porn, and it was about family fucking each other, and it was a movie. Like, it was like a production fucking movie.
Like incestual fucking each other?
Yes.
Actors or just fucking...
Like, they were porn stars, but they were playing as actors. Right. And the plot and like the summary and everything, father fucking daughters, mother's fucking son, brother and sister fucking each other. And it was during the 70s. So
What about dad and son? Taking him out to the garage and teach him a lesson?
So I did a book report about it.
It didn't go that far.
I was shocked.
It didn't go that far. It didn't go that far.
There was a line
but
in this
the son,
point.
But the son
Till
did.
Part six.
Hold up. But the son did bang the aunt.
Oh, the aunt came over?
The aunt came over and he banged his aunt. But it was during like the 70s time. It had that wild wild fucking 70s music and shit. And I'm like,
fucking porn, man.
I'm like, thank
porn
you.
Porn fucks people up.
And I'm like, yo.
Yes.
Me.
Porn.
It desensitizes you.
This is the first one he ever saw. Parts 1, 3, 2.
And he hasn't looked back yet.
You damn right. From there, I went to Debbie Does Dallas. And then I went from Creepers Jeepers Freakers. And then
you watching a video with somebody putting the damn airplane oxygen mask on the vagina.
Yeah, I could do that. I can watch all that.
Fast forward to now, he's on a grandma porn. He's got it all.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's just a lover, this guy.
Yeah,
he loves
erotica.
Wait a minute, you guys trying to say I got a problem?
No. You wouldn't be you without that. You're the super loving man.
Because you guys watch porn, too. You just got
no, I don't watch porn.
You fucking lie.
I absolutely don't watch porn.
You just lie. You're lying.
I have watched porn.
You guys
porn.
Watch porn.
I've watched porn.
I'm not a fan
you
watch porn?
I've watched porn before, but I don't watch porn now. I haven't watched porn in years.
Oh, okay.
I no longer masturbate, either.
Really?
I don't. It's wasted energy.
Yeah.
Save all my energy for physical sex.
That's your
really?
Chi.
Save
that's
all
your
my chi. Sexual chemistry.
Yo, man.
My sexual energy.
I'm telling you, but you got to save that shit.
Physical sex. I don't burn it.
I don't, what?
That's right.
That's your life
crazy?
Force right
no,
there.
No, not crazy
Wait
at all.
Man, how many nuts do you get?
When I go?
Yeah, when you
as
go.
As many as I want.
As many as you want?
As many as I want.
You're a fucking
liar. Golden God.
You said that shit like a king. Yeah. As many as I want.
Yeah, I'm regal. I'm regal as fuck around here.
You sound like one of those
I get
guys.
As many nuts as I want.
As many as I want. As many as I please, dear sir.
Well, isn't that the end result? That's what everybody wants.
I'm saying.
You leave when you're satisfied. I don't go to an all-I-can-eat buffet and fucking walk out of there hungry.
Oh.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay,
all right. I go until I
well,
until
so,
I'm
all right, let me ask the Golden God this question.
Okay.
What? How many
20
nuts?
Inches.
No.
Soft.
I'm sorry.
How many nuts satisfies you? Does one Good nut satisfies.
I like to take about 20 nuts in the face.
Sometimes one real solid intense nut get me there.
That's it.
Yeah,
solid intense nut.
Yeah,
and you don't want no more.
I mean, yeah, I want my legs to. I want to feel like a baby deer trying to just fucking try to get my legs.
You want to feel like a newborn giraffe.
I want to feel like Gumby. You know what I mean? Like, just that's good for me. Yeah.
All right. So when you feel like that's not good enough for you, you go for two. Three.
I'll go for two. I'll go round two and see how I feel from there.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah. Let's see.
How often do you go ahead and pull a triple double?
A triple double? Yeah. That's five or three times in 2 days. What's a triple double?
Triple double, man. Come on, man.
Loaded question there. I mean, I haven't gone three nuts in years.
What?
Yeah.
What the fuck is wrong with you?
Because I kill it with one. Why do I need to go three?
Damn.
It's a fucking massacre. It's over.
Just move on to something
Tom
else.
Tom Cruise. Of nuts.
That's
Mission Impossible.
Thank
that
you.
Shit.
I was just going there. Thank you. Nice.
Yo.
Yes, shit. Sir. That's how we do it.
Holy shit.
Nah, I feel you on that.
Listen,
man.
You're the same way?
Well, you know what, man? I'm not rich enough to be a three nut guy right now.
Oh. You gotta
you know
be
what I
rich?
Mean? Like, I have. I could be a three nut guy if I have to. That's every once in a while.
Yeah, it's gotta be special.
I got shit to do.
He's married and shit.
Yeah, I'm married. I gotta wash dishes and shit.
Oh, oh
I gotta
shit.
Get up and go fucking make some money. Right. I gotta do shit.
So two of your nuts are in the shower. Uh-huh. And just one. Is I got
hey,
you.
Listen. Okay. Listen. The fact that they are nuts is what counts.
Right.
Stop being so negative.
I would go with that one.
Fireball. Right. What about you? Just one good solid?
I don't think I've came in like a year.
Huh?
Everyone hates me and I'm suicidal. And I'm just not feeling
I don't want to hear that, man.
You need
come on, tell
you
the
need
truth.
To bust at least one then.
Yeah. Well, I'm afraid
I
would change
like to see
the world
more tight
if I
play. So you just so, all right, we're just going to say, we're going to give you just a good old one nut.
We're gonna buy you a nut. That's what I hope you meant, right? We're not gonna give him a nut.
Yeah, I think I'm only good for one.
You know,
yeah,
he's only good for one nut.
Two, if you're really nice to me.
That's buy him dinner.
That's amazing. You know, I must say, I applaud you guys.
Why? For not masturbating?
Right.
You're not
you're
masturbating.
Just squirting out all over the place.
And not emptying your tank.
I need to save that.
Yeah. I that's empty my tank.
How many nuts do you need?
A week.
Yeah.
Yes.
Like 70.
Triple digits or
10
what?
A day.
How many nuts are busting a week?
Yeah.
About 15.
Okay,
do you front load it or do you just space it out over the week?
How do you do it? Front load it. What are you talking about? Squats?
I'm talking like, yo, it's the first leg of the week you're just pumping away like a rabbit and then it kind of tails off, you know?
Tires out.
I mean, how do you do it? You have to conserve something somewhere.
What do you mean conserve? Where's all
your, when you hit the quota, do you stop?
Where does all your cum come from? Like, where don't you run out of cum?
His nut.
I'm a stutter.
Look at how much cum he's full of. Look at
this guy. He does look like a cum drop.
He's practically dripping cum right now out of his pores. Full of it.
I can spit on a bitch if she's pregnant.
You gotta be careful with that, dude.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah. You gotta just fucking be happy with two.
He's sitting in a pool of semen right now.
Yeah.
Hey, listen.
You might be pregnant. Go home and take a test.
Hey, listen. On the average night, I want three nuts.
Okay.
Okay.
Average night. So you can go home tonight and get three nuts.
Yeah. See, what I'll do is I'll do vag, I'll do anal, and then I'll get a blowjob. That's three nuts. What the fuck is wrong with you, motherfucker? I don't get
why
it.
Why don't you go blowjob first?
Huh?
Why don't you go blowjob first?
Ain't that like the warm-up? That's like the warm-up.
No. I'm already hard.
Blowjob is the treadmill.
Nope. I'm already there. I don't need that. I don't even like blowjobs is not even really my thing.
I like foot jobs.
I just like getting my dick sucked, okay? But, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
I like getting my dick sucked. But on that third nut, as you guys know, that third nut, you know, you got to work for that.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, that's labor intensive.
Yeah,
right
so,
there.
That's a lot of cocaine for me.
So, okay. I'll say, but listen, I'm about to break it down to you. Why would you work? Why don't you let her work?
Have you never gotten one nut? It was like, you know what? I'm good with that.
Don't you have shit to do
in
your day?
No, I tried that.
Yeah. Like, what the? I have shit to do.
I tried that.
There ain't no TV shows that you watch that you want to get to.
No. I fucking bust a nut, and then after that, I sit there, and then I start thinking, and I start looking at some more pussy on my phone, and then I'm like, oh.
Damn.
I think I want to fuck again.
Remember in the beginning when you asked if we thought you had a problem? I would like to change my vote.
Right.
Listen, you do you. That's what I love about you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're just I
thought every guy did that.
Maybe when I was younger, yeah, I was all about that. But now I'm just like,
yeah.
What do you mean when you're young?
I think some people were like institutionalized for what you're talking about.
Yeah.
Just like 20, 30 years ago. You know, they'd lock them away in institution. Chronic, you know, whatever. Yeah.
Absolutely.
I could have sworn.
Ejaculator.
Look, I could have sworn every
They didn't look at masturbation as like some kind of like disease problem.
Yeah, they did. Back then. They thought it was a complete.
You go blind.
Yeah.
They thought you was mentally ill if you masturbated.
Because your mind is just focused on what your mind is on. So it's constantly sex, 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 and then that's
No, it's not. I don't always think about sex.
You obviously know a lot of shit because you knew the Brooke Shields. Oh, no, wait. That was sex-related, that Brooke Shields thing.
Yeah, it was.
It all goes back to sex.
Hold up. So you're trying to say I
What's
got a problem.
What's your favorite
color? You are an expert,
sex.
though.
So you're saying I got a problem?
No.
I would say you're an expert in the field. That's how I would categorize
I got a problem?
It.
No, ain't nothing wrong with that, man. If you could bust three nuts every day,
bust a few for me.
Ain't no problem. Because you got a lot of motherfuckers who can't.
They
that's
can.
Unattainable.
Hmm.
So that's good. That's a good thing, man.
Right. You should
be proud
of
that. You're in good sexual health.
Right. You'll probably die a happy
It's
man.
The mental aspect we're worried about.
That's the way I want to go out. I want to go out pumping.
It sounds like you will be.
Okay,
he's pumping right now. You see him? He's starting to gyrate? But save it. Wait, because I feel like. This is a perfect time for me to segue into the new game show we have here.
New game show.
Yeah. 3, 2, 1.
Welcome. Damaged Goods presents Put Up or Shut Up. With your host, the Golden Guy.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Fireball Jesus. Welcome to the Put Up or Shut Up show. Here at Damaged Goods, a few months back, my prestigious co-host, Sith Lord, has put the call out to our listeners to obtain breast milk.
Ah.
All right. So me being the golden god, I was able to obtain you some breast milk from...
Fake name.
I got some breast milk.
That? Ah, get the fuck out of here. You got breast milk?
Yeah.
No way.
This is legitimate breast milk.
Whose breast milk is it?
Fake name.
Oh, this is going to suck.
He's pulling out breast milk with his hands.
That shit's gonna splatter going to splatter everywhere. Okay.
Complete with bottle and everything.
Oh, wow. It's in a baby bottle.
There it is.
Get your diapers
ready,
people.
2 ounces of refrigerated breast milk.
Okay.
Holy shit.
The bet is, will you drink it down?
Is it from a white lady or a black lady?
It's a clean source of breast milk.
I'm racist as fuck.
Flavor preference?
Well, no, seriously, who's it from?
Fake name. It's legit breast milk. Just squozed this morning.
You ask the fans. It is time, Sith, to put up or shut up.
Am I getting some money for this or something? Or am I? What
you
the
you were the one who
benefits
call
of breast milk.
You asked the listeners to send you in breast milk. Well, guess what, motherfucker? Breast milk showed up. So here it is.
Don't waste that.
Okay, but all right.
Don't waste that.
I need to know whose DNA am I drinking now?
They're perfectly clean. All the tests have shown.
Are they organic?
Yes.
Yes.
Grass-fed, cage-free.
Free range, the whole shit. Will you
That's
drink
cage-free
this breast milk?
Will I drink 2 ounces of breast milk?
It is time to put up or shut up still.
I don't see why not.
I drank more breast milk by accident.
I don't know. I've sucked plenty of titties with breast milk.
See what you got.
You got a straw?
No, I don't.
Do you want an umbrella in that shit too, motherfucker? Just drink it.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. Yeah.
Shit.
Oh, that's what's up.
Shit. Woo.
God damn!
Sith Lord, ladies and gentlemen.
The one, the only. And he put up. So everyone can
he's actually very natural.
Damn.
Do you
want
to tell
you like
us
know,
about
you know
the
breast
texture.
Milk? You know your breast milk.
Yeah.
What does she have for breakfast?
She's organic. Totally. Where it is.
She's a chain smoker and an AIDS patient.
I'm suing you.
We pranked you, bro.
I don't have Cosby. Sorry.
No, no, it's all right.
Anyone on the Instagram feed tonight?
Yeah, there's some people on here.
Thank you for checking it out, people. Make sure you check us out at damagegoodsinc.com for more.
Real Psycho Steve is in here. I see that.
Psycho! All right. Well, come check us out, damagegoodsinc.com. Catch you later. There it is. Sith Lord.
Don't be betting me. Next time you bring some pussy down here or something.
Damn, man. That was impressive, dude. That was...
It's milk.
Yo.
Look. You talked the talk. You walked
the
walk.
You walked the walk, man.
You fucking walked the walk.
You took breast milk to the face. Strange breast milk.
To the face. To the fucking face.
Yep.
He fucking showed
you
up.
Said, fuck that shit.
Wow.
I'm not letting anything stand in between me and destiny, and you took that shit.
Wow.
It's milk.
Could you tell if that was, like, human or not? I'm not going to tell you if it was or not, but can you tell?
It didn't taste human.
It was actually dog's milk. Just wanted to tell
Human's milk is a little sweeter.
That was actual human.
That was human milk.
That's what I'm saying. Whoever it is, they eat pretty good.
Wow.
Because if they,
I'm sure he'll appreciate it.
Reach out to Sith if you want some more of that.
If they had a bad diet, you could taste.
If this listener reached out and wanted you to perform some sort of sucking right from the root source of the milk, are you available?
No, I'm not available to do that.
Oh, okay.
All right. Wait a minute.
Sorry, lady.
I don't do two shows a night.
He's like, wait a minute. I'll drink some breast milk. I'll watch some porn, but I ain't sucking no milk out of no titties. That's what you're saying?
Well, I'm saying I only have a rule. I have a rule.
Okay, what's that?
He has one rule.
Fuck everything.
Only.
If he's got a pussy, it's good to go.
Only breast milk I'm drinking is for my baby mamas.
That's not true.
Except on a dare. I want on a dare.
You came to fucking play, bro. Give me some of that.
Man.
So, all right, dude.
Right
amen,
on, bro.
Baby.
You guys damaged
amen.
Fucking good.
Amen,
bro.
Baby.
You know,
right.
Amen. I looked at it as just milk.
Yeah, well, that's what it was.
Yeah, that's what it was.
Would you have
protein?
Used
or at least
that
you think
like
it
on cereal
was.
Or something?
Huh?
Would that have went gone like good over cereal? Or?
Oh yeah. I would have put that on cereal.
Good taste,
yeah.
Flavor.
I mean, that's really what we supposed to drink. That's milk for us.
Oh yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah.
Cow's milk ain't for humans.
When you're a child,
how long?
Cow's milk ain't for humans.
But that's a great point.
That's
how long?
Cows.
Yeah.
How long until Whole Foods or Trader Joe's is selling breast milk?
I give it 10 years.
It could happen.
Yeah,
I give it 10 years. They're already farming breast milk.
I don't think you'll never.
You can
happen.
Grow tits. I'm gonna do that.
No, they're regular
I need some
tits.
Seeds right now.
They're regular tits.
Okay,
but. You have people who do sell breast milk. Like
yeah,
you can go online
millions.
And you can find breast milk.
Yeah,
breast milk
millions.
Is a superfood, man.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
For
mother's
a
milk.
Yeah. You know what else is a very super high
milk? There's a lot of
milk?
Hormones in there. You don't
roach
that
milk.
Shit.
Yeah, we talked about
what?
This.
Roach
milk? Yeah, there's just too much.
How do you milk a roach? That sounds hard as hell.
Next
how
episode.
Much milk comes
stop
out
it.
Of
it.
We got somebody to donate right. Fresh roach milk.
How many roaches do you have to milk?
How many roaches
now,
do you have
you
to
get,
milk?
Get your hands on some roach milk?
I'll do it.
Where does the milk come
then
from in a roach?
Huh?
Like, how many? Like, how do you get the milk from a roach?
I don't know, sir.
Very carefully, I'd imagine. Can't just go all in with that. You gotta extract it gently. Right. It sounds like a process. To me, I don't want to deal with that.
I'm just telling you, right. It's the best milk on earth.
Do they sell that? they sell roach milk?
Yes.
Where?
Seafood,
Seatown.
Home Depot.
I seen a documentary, and I don't think it's over in the United States yet.
Of course not.
But they are absolutely serious about producing tons and tons of this shit, and it's way, way more nutritious.
Can we get this verified? Can we get this verified? I need to know.
What?
I mean, how much milk does a roach produce?
Right.
I don't know, but they
produce a fraction of a drop, like a pinhead. How many fucking roaches do you need?
Where is it available?
But you know what? You know what you're thinking? You're thinking of that common roach. It's not that common roach.
Okay.
It's a different type of roach.
They talk about a roach with nipples. This roach has nipples. They milk the shit.
Okay.
Okay.
Them big ass
they put a little bucket,
roaches.
Their little tiny bucket under the roach's nipples.
These roaches are huge. They're like fucking damn near.
I'm a cowboy from the ghetto.
Holy
I heard
shit.
Roaches all day.
Roach milk. I put roach milk into my
genius.
Search.
This guy's a motherfucking genius.
Into my search engine. It you know what came pot. Up? Roach right. milk. Roach milk for sale. Roach milk Good. Meme and roach milk superfood.
Oh, this,
let's look
this,
at roach
I'm
milk
out.
Superfood.
I'm out. This fucking guy.
Sith has destroyed the room for the seventh time already.
I told you, man.
All right. And this is a men's health. This is a men's health.
Is that your secret of three nuts?
Article.
Roach milk?
Cockroach milk is the disgusting superfood trend.
The word cock is in it. It's so
die.
Transparent.
Yeah.
I mean, absolute zero.
One, hey, fireball. What is one this? South African company is already offering ice cream made of insect roach milk.
Look at
oh,
that.
Oh, shit.
On to idea yeah. already.
Nice. What the fuck is roach milk? In short, it's the cockroach equivalent of human breast milk. The female Pacific beetle. One of the rare cockroach species
told you.
That gives
Six
birth to live bugs feeds her babies milk. What the fuck? I do not want to run into these damn roaches.
And they're huge.
These like, roaches no. make milk?
They're huge. And they're like this fucking big, bro. They're huge.
They feed their babies with milk.
Yep.
That's that's pretty disgusting. I don't think I'd put that in my mouth. Like, I don't need a super, like, I don't want to live that bad. It's not that important to me. I'm
yes,
not
you
drinking
do.
Roach milk. No, I don't. I mean, I really don't. I'm not drinking. Like, I have certain lines, dude. It's okay.
If I gave
you draw
it
a line
okay.
at roach milk.
If I gave it
that's
to you.
That's one of the lines. Yeah. There's probably a few before that one, actually.
But here's the famous line for you. If I gave it to you and then didn't tell you what it was, you still drink it.
What I'd have to it? See how it tastes. I got to see how it tastes.
But lucky for you.
Yeah. I got to see. Cause, I mean,
we got
like,
a few around here that need a milking.
Because, I mean, if it's healthy, like, I'm all about healthy shit. Like, if it's healthy.
Well,
what's
it's
wrong
totally,
with you people?
As he
wait, what
read,
do you mean you people?
I don't mean black people. Okay. I just yeah, mean my, you two people that happen to be black.
Well, if it's supposed to be healthy.
It is.
And cow's milk is horrible for you.
Horrible.
Yeah,
horrible.
Yeah, it's absolutely. Hush. So why would roach lactate be any better for you? It's not.
Because eating roaches
it's gotta be.
Is good for you.
It's got to be.
It's got to be,
then
man.
Not drinking it or then cow's milk. Cow's
no.
milk, I agree, is horrible for you. However,
yes.
why would roach milk be good for you?
You got to look it
maybe
up,
maybe it's
fireball.
Just a different, it's a different makeup. I mean, yeah. a roach is like an alien. Like, a roach is a different.
They live for
a different
billions
kind of, animal,
of fucking
right?
years, man.
Than us, you know? Like, us being mammals and roaches being roaches.
Exactly.
Yeah, but I don't know. You know, it's just too disgusting. I don't want to live that bad. You know, like,
I think
as long as I don't have to milk them. If I don't have to milk them,
but a big condensating glass of nice roach milk.
If I didn't, if you didn't know it was roach milk, you would drink it, bro.
No, I would not.
Yes, you would. You drink milk?
I think we've officially bottomed out here.
You drink? Hold up.
I ain't drinking the goddamn roach milk.
But you, I smoke roaches. I don't drink them.
Hold it. Wait a minute. But you drink milk though.
No.
No,
no
I
one
don't.
Drinks
milk. Oh, okay. You don't,
oh, you
drink,
don't
milk.
Drink milk, period.
No.
No, I don't drink
oh,
milk.
Oh, hell no, you ain't drinking no roach milk. You don't drink milk.
I don't drink milk. Almond
I don't
milk.
Drink breast milk. I don't drink roach milk.
No, see,
I don't
now,
drink
chocolate
any
almond.
Any milk.
You see, now I'm about to break something down to you.
Almond milk is no good for you, I know.
That milk I just drunk tastes better than almond milk. And that's facts.
Right. Can I try some? Spit it in my mouth, big boy.
Oh, Jesus.
Baby right. bird me. Come on.
Baby bird me. Wow. I thought I created that term.
I'm just telling you, man.
That's I'm awesome. You're awesome.
I'm in milk.
Thank you.
The golden
Andre
guy.
Andre McSween.
Give it up for the golden guy.
Oh. There it is.
I'm in milk. It's just that.
Almond milk is good when it's chocolate and it's in my fucking protein drinks after I
almond milk
fucking
is pretty good.
Bag it out.
Yeah,
man,
I can't do it almond milk.
Mm-mm. Yeah, it's
can't
not
do
too
it.
Bad.
I can't do
I
it.
I hear you get bitch tits from it.
I like coconut
no,
milk.
That's soy milk.
That's soy milk.
Oh, soy milk.
Yeah.
Okay.
yeah. I got bitch tits? No.
Right,
I drink almond
right,
milk all the time.
I
soy
you
milk
love your
will
almond
give
milk.
You bitch tits.
But
I like
because some
it's estrogenic.
I think I'll do the coconut milk before I
that's
do it.
That's not bad either, but you know, I don't need too
just
much coconut
water.
Taste.
What's wrong
life.
With you people? Just drink fucking water. What do you have to have milk and fancy flavor?
I just
for?
I drink
water's fine.
Well,
I drink
fucking
protein.
We ain't camels. That's why we need some goddamn flavor in our damn life. We need to keep drinking goddamn water.
Water.
I mean,
always got water.
I grew up in the woods, motherfucker.
Have some fireball.
My dad used to throw me a jug of water and go tell me to go play outside and drink water all goddamn day. I don't want no damn water. I want some flavor.
Did you drink out of the hose when you were young?
Fuck yeah, still do.
And milk came out of that bitch.
Your neighbor's hose?
Huh?
Your neighbor's hoes?
No, God. What the fuck are you talking about, dude?
Oh, wrong story. Yeah. I get them all confused.
What the fuck are you talking
about? Wait, that was last
neighbor's
week.
Neighbor's hoes. Is that something? Is this like?
He's trying to say.
No, that was last
you
week.
You used to blow bubbles when you were a kid? He's back in town. He's looking for you.
That was last week with the septic tank story that never made air.
It will one day.
One day. Yeah, check it out on the best of.
Just fucking dubbing shows, man.
What?
Why you guys dubbed that show?
We haven't even had a chance to listen to that pile of shit.
So what? Well, listen to the
we
pile
of shit.
We were
waiting for you to edit.
Yeah. Actually, we it's in your inbox.
I've been meaning to give shit about that.
I don't edit shit.
We noticed. So then what are you busting our dick about?
Because you guys want to can it.
Because
No. We'll harvest it later down the line.
Look, you got a lot of harvest shit. We're going to grow a fucking farm over here.
Yeah,
how much
are.
Shit you going to harvest?
Because we were preoccupied reinventing the network and bringing it into the 21st century.
Damaged Goods Network.
Mm.
Right.
Shout out to you motherfuckers.
Mm. Who's in the
productive
network?
Meeting
yesterday. We fire
killers
anybody
on
yet?
This fucking team, man. We got fucking killers on this team.
We fire anybody
they'll
yet?
Slit your throat, take your money, and rape your wife.
No, no one's damn. Been no one's been fired.
When are we going to fire somebody?
You want to be
certified.
The one to... We'll put you in. I'll tell you what we'll do.
I will be the charge.
He's
of
HR.
Firing.
You're yep. HR. From
HR.
Now.
I will fire HR. A motherfucker. Head all nigga right. In charge.
All right. Nice.
HNIC.
Head, okay. Head.
Can you be bribed?
Oh, yeah.
With oh, yes. Oh,
very
with milk. Yes. Yes. No.
Yeah.
Everybody
I,
knows.
I can't
you
be
stay
bribed.
On this network, there's ways.
Yes. Just, I like. Getting
luckily, it's male dominated around here.
Yeah.
So you might really, get the wrong kind of milk.
Well, he really gets you know what he wants then.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hot dogs, get your hot dogs here.
Yeah, ain't that something? I tell you what, I don't think I want this job no more.
Wait,
just give it to Tony, bro. Let Tony be the HR guy.
No, hell no. Hey. Tony don't want that shit either. Fuck that.
Why?
No. Listen. I'll fire somebody if they need to get off the network.
Who needs to get off the network?
What?
Who needs to go?
You want me to go there?
People out
sure.
Right now.
I'll go there. You want me to go there?
Why not? Let's
I'll go there.
I'm right there with you, bro.
Hey.
All right.
All right.
Well, one name, though. Just say one name.
One name?
And I'll tell you if I agree or if you're totally
not, you don't
fucked
want me to name
up.
The whole podcast? Just the person.
Who has to go from the network?
Who has to go from the network?
Yep.
You said
gotta
you had
go.
A name.
Yep.
One name.
Yep.
I'm sorry.
Fake name.
Oh,
you elevator go. Music.
Oh, gotta go.
Wow, I was not expecting
cold
that.
Cold blood.
One. Wow.
She's proving to me that she's doing? Fucking worthless.
She's worthless.
Worthless.
Damn.
Because someone's not producing drops for Seth.
She's not producing anything for me. So therefore,
No blowjobs.
No hand jobs. I can't even donkey punch her. She's all the way
donkey punch. I don't
you
know what that means.
I
want
to. I just wanted a couple drops. I can't even fucking get that from her. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if it's because I'm black.
Drops of
I don't
what?
Know. I don't know what's going on. I just want drops of tea. And she won't do it. Like, she's like, this motherfucker got a force field. Like, he's got a fucking force field around this motherfucker. So, she won't, like, she's scared to touch this motherfucker. I asked this bitch fucking 3 fucking months ago. And she still didn't fucking do it. Like, what the fuck is going on, man? She's got to go. You're fired.
Oof.
Harsh.
You do not.
And then you know what she tells me through our little group thing? I know who to bow down to. I know who to kiss ass to.
Whose ass you got to kiss around?
Right,
here?
It doesn't get you far.
I'm like,
trying to kiss all the ass, and I have no benefits out of it.
I said, wait a minute,
people.
Honey.
I just kiss it for fun.
There's 3 asses you got to kiss. It's just not one.
Right. I prefer to have the ring kissed. Kiss the ring, not the ass.
And no, kiss my hairy ass, okay?
All 3 cheeks.
All 3, with the balls hanging. With the balls hanging in below. Give me a reach around.
You got a
3-cheeked
ass?
Just for her.
I'm just saying, man. That's
how niggas do.
She runs the website shitty, okay? All right, we need to go there.
Well, if you were on the network
not
call
really.
Yesterday, you'd notice that we were completely revamping everything.
Right.
Okay.
You missed the call, though, so to
listen,
she was on the call and you weren't.
I don't care.
How you going to explain this one away.
I don't
now.
Care. Listen.
I'm listening.
Everybody is.
Listen.
The world
you're
is.
The HR department. Yeah. So
I don't care. I don't
you
care
have the final
if, listen,
say.
I don't care if I wasn't at the meeting.
Okay.
Apparently you don't.
No, I don't care.
Actually, I knew that yesterday. Long before you were ever invited to the meeting.
But listen.
But anyway.
Because when you know why? Because when it's time for some action, I show up. I'm there. You know what I'm saying?
This is it. Gotta go to work.
I'm spitting hot fire right now, you know?
Right.
All
right? Sexual frustration built up, I think.
No.
I see that you've been trying to hit her up for some sort of...
nuts.
Side action, but it hasn't been working, so...
Do
we sense
a little
frustration? Yeah.
No.
A little vendetta because...
That's all well and fun and game.
A little Cosby action could
that's
fix all that.
That's all well and fun and game.
He would still have this opinion, regardless.
She swears that she's some type of Terminator in bed. You know, like she's some, you know,
right.
You know,
put up or shut up, right? You put up or shut up.
Yeah, let's
she
go.
She should put up or shut up.
No, I'm not even worried about it. I already know, okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right? I already know what I'll do to her, okay?
All right.
What would you do to her?
Oh, no, he asked the question. No,
see,
step
the
by
strawberry
step
shortcake.
I need to know.
Cleveland Siegel. Cleveland Steeler.
Top rope.
What's the top rope?
You don't know what the top rope is?
No, what's the top rope?
That's an actual thing.
Yeah,
I'm so old.
What's the top rope?
Like when? Are you guys serious?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you know what the chicken cutlet is?
I heard of it.
Okay. Do you know what it is?
I heard of it.
Okay. So there you go. So I, right. Same thing. I heard of the top rope. I just don't know what it is. What's the definition?
The top rope is when you stand over a bitch and you. You know, you act like you're about to do the jump down, but instead you jump down and you have your dick and try to land in her mouth.
Oh, so you're jumping off the turnbuckle.
Yeah, like top rope.
And planting your dick in her mouth.
Yeah, well, you jump
and
over.
And she's sitting there with her mouth open waiting for it.
She's laying on the bed.
Oh, so you're jumping from the turnbuckle to the bed.
Well, you literally, it's not literally the turnbuckle, but you're on the bed, you jump up off the bed.
And you're going to stab her in the mouth with your dick.
I don't know.
That's a stab
to the mouth with the dick. Right.
Yes.
That's what the top rope is. Uh-huh. I've never, ever felt
I like get my
the
dick
need
how many people
to get that creative.
What about the chicken cutlet? Right, yeah. Close the door on the chicken cutlet.
Oh, yeah. Well, I don't know what the chicken cutlet is. You're
fucking your best gal on the beach. And you pull it out and slide it in the sand. And get it all nice and breaded and put it right back in. There you go. Chicken cutlet.
Sounds like a sandpaper heaven.
Oh, it's not heaven. No one involved.
Damn.
Maybe get some crabs.
Ugh.
Oh.
Yeah, these are all things that, like, really.
So, what would you do to her? Was the question.
Use.
Not a New York beach.
Yeah, well, no. Hypodermics.
No, you know, listen. She's a dominant woman.
Right.
Okay?
Allegedly.
Allegedly. I don't think she's fucking dominant, man. You know what I'm saying?
That's your gripe here, yes.
You know what I'm saying?
I'm picking up on that.
We're going to have a fucking war. We're going to have a war in there, man, because I ain't backing down. I ain't backing down.
What are you guys worrying over?
Sex! TV!
Sex war?
This is a sex war?
Yeah,
what is
man.
Porn fingers?
Sick.
It's going nuts around here.
You're
going
to show up.
It's a
up
slobber knot.
I'm going to
jump
show
off
up
the top rope.
I'm going to show up with knee pads and fucking elbow pads, man.
And you're
going to fucking helmet.
Stab her in the mouth with your dick.
A carpet kicker. He's going to show up with everything.
Listen, man.
Bam!
You guys never went into, like, having sex like it's a fucking war?
Yes.
Like, this is, all right, then.
I've had hate sex.
All right. Yes. That's what this is.
Oh, so it's just got to happen. You two hate each other, and you just got to fuck like animals to get the differences settled. Is that what you said?
I don't know about fuck first. It's going to be a little altercation first.
Oh,
you know what I'm
saying? Yeah.
I got to give her.
Wink, wink. Wink, you can't.
I got to give her a little. I gotta give her a little Tennessee hello, you know?
Yeah, please.
What's that?
Oh, like, you know, punch her in the mouth, give her a knock a couple of teeth out.
What?
I'm starting to wonder if you made up the top rope and the Tennessee hello.
No!
But I've heard of the, what is it?
What is it?
Jesus Christ.
Tennessee
you have a lot
hello,
of abusive,
man.
Good though.
The hillbilly hello is my
favorite. Yeah!
She seems like a nice young lady.
Who? Shade?
Yeah.
Get the, she is nice!
What the
it's
fuck?
Oh, you're doing that because she's nice.
Right.
No.
She's overly nice and he has to fuck it out of her.
No. She's not.
It's Sith who's the scumbag.
No, listen.
Now I am the master.
She's a nice person, okay? She just has.
Allegedly.
Allegedly. She just has a very dominant sexual spirit
okay
that I must break.
Oh, okay. So you're on a mission.
Yeah.
And it's her will that you break her.
I'm the Vader.
Like the wild horse that she's
in. She needs to be
you're
broken.
Her Vader.
I am her Vader.
Okay.
She
I
needs
gotcha
to be broken into.
Okay. You got to do the force choke? I love the force choke.
Oh, yeah. So she'd be running around whooping dudes' asses all the time. You know what I'm saying? She's running around meeting these little wimpy fuckers. You know what I'm saying? And that's what she do, that's what she does. You know, that's who she dominates.
I don't know if
yeah.
You
yeah.
don't think so?
Well, those are the people that want to be dominated.
I don't understand men that want to be dominated.
Me yeah, neither.
Me neither.
Right, yeah, me neither.
You want to know who dominates men? This fucking guy.
You know who dominates men? Family court.
Yeah. Oh.
All right.
Oh.
Too early?
No.
No. Right.
Whatever you want.
All right.
Okay.
Floor is yours.
Whoa. What's going on with you?
I'm sorry, guys.
Hey, we have this new thing we're doing. Yeah. Yeah. We actually listen to our guests and what they have to say.
Oh.
Yeah.
Instead of railroading them.
Tell us about your family court.
Yeah,
family court. Your kids
go
are
ahead.
Gone.
Let it out.
No, I was just in family
You're
court.
You're deadbeat dad?
No, I'm not, but not by any means at
all.
Not by any means.
Is somebody claiming that you are deadbeat dad?
Of course.
Ah, hold up. Was this claim by...
Do you have an Amber Alert active right now against you or no? No? Okay.
Was this claim by a black woman?
Maybe.
Was this claim made by a Latino woman?
Definitely not.
Does she have breast milk?
She doesn't have breast milk.
Okay. I have to know these things.
Yeah.
One more question. Is this woman from New York City?
Does she live in New York City or is she like originally
from
New York City?
Is she originally from New York City?
Nah, not originally from New York City.
Okay, that's all I want to know.
Yeah.
They hate when I ask where people are from. They hate it.
I have a question for you though, Sith.
Okay.
You got all the information.
Mm-hmm.
And your conclusion is?
My conclusion is that he's an innocent man for whatever this woman is about to say.
This guy right here is brilliant.
Innocent. He's been right all night. You're definitely
I would fucking, you know.
He's batting 1,000.
Yeah, I would not cross him tonight. He's got the force working.
Most impressive.
I can tell you right now, just meeting this guy, and he's already told me he was raised by women. I know this guy didn't mistreat a woman.
Mm. He's not,
you know what I'm saying?
Psychological.
So it's whatever,
fucking,
whatever fabrication.
That breast milk, man.
It made him smart.
That breast milk settled in there and got up in his DNA and
it
shit.
It literally, they say, it makes you smarter. Last week, this guy was retarded. Now, look at him. He's brilliant.
He was Downs with the syndrome last
the
week.
Fuck out of here.
Now he's a genius.
Yeah, you were down with the syndrome.
He's fucking...
the fuck out of here.
He's solving equations on the wall behind firewall.
That's
he's
fucked up.
Wow.
Unfucking believable.
I'm just saying,
what's that
man,
damn movie with the... Was that Beautiful Mind?
Yeah, Beautiful Mind.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We don't have the glass windows, but we got a cement wall.
Yeah.
Perhaps it is good to have a beautiful mind. But an even greater gift is to discover a beautiful heart. A beautiful mind.
A beautiful mind.
Unbelievable. Yeah. Wow. Thank you, Sith.
You're welcome.
Fuck.
What's this about, man?
Well, this is some fireball brought to me.
Yeah, so...
Fireball, what's this?
This is the next thing. This is going to blow, I'm telling you, because these guys are good. It's called Street Beefs. And what it is they have these backyard fights where they do boxing, MMA, and also if you have a beef, they'll just have like an untimed fight. This is out of Virginia, and these guys have spent some time in jail, and they're trying to get people off the street.
So? You think?
It's actually, no.
The teardrop tattoo, just give it away.
Check it out. check it out. So it's actually a great thing because they're saying, like, put down the guns, stop all, like, the gang shit, and fight it out in this guy's yard, in his backyard. I forget this guy's name over here, but... but
Paco.
Paco. Paco. He looks like a Paco right here.
Oh, yeah,
right.
Paco
so,
Loco.
Paco Loco.
The tatted up guy... He's like a boxer.
He just looks like a problem.
Yeah, he does.
He's a problem.
Well, he definitely is.
So apparently, they're starting to catch a little bit of fame. ESPN was checking them out, like in their yard and shit like that. And some people started putting comments up that the guy with all the tats was a pedophile or got clipped on some kind of sex charge.
Mm.
So they want to come out and explain that this is not right. It's not a sex charge. And their explanation is just great.
Wait a minute, so there's no fighting?
Yeah, did we get to see the fights?
You can see the fights if you want, but I just think the explanation of how...
I'll listen to the explanation, but I want to see some fights.
Mighty Mouse. This is the fighter's name.
He's already stealing people's identities.
Yeah, well, a punch in the face.
Street Beach, Scarface here. I got my brother, Mighty Mouse. Listen, man, we're going to cut right to the chase. No bullshitting around. I'm going to tell you something. We always are up front with you here at Street Beats, and I'm going to let you know that I stand by my guys 100%. I wouldn't stand by anything that I thought was wrong or bullshit. So let's cut right to it. There's a bunch of you haters in the comments section posting my man's charge, saying, yo, Mighty Mouse is a sex offender, blah, blah, blah. So let's square that away right now. I'm going to speak first, then I'm going to let Mighty Mouse speak.
Is he the Dana White of the fucking street beefs?
If this thing blows, like I think it will, even though it seems completely illegal.
Dana Latino.
Yeah, he will be the Dana White. And he fights, too.
Does he?
Yeah.
Scarface.
Oh, Scarface, that's his name. Yeah. Thank you.
Scarface and Mighty Mouse.
It could be a little long here in the beginning, yeah. But it's worth it because...
I hope so.
So far, so good. It's everything that fucking Damaged Goods is.
Pedophiles?
No. He's not a pedo. Listen to the explanation. Don't take it from me.
Okay.
Here's the deal. Mighty Mouse was put on the sex offender registry for some bullshit when he was younger. He didn't touch nobody. It had nothing to do with that. Just like myself, he was out on some street shit. He got caught around some dudes that were pimping. Somebody underage came into the mix, and that's the long and the short of it. Now, I'm going to let him explain a little bit more. Then you guys can take it from there. But
the production quality is through the roof here. Right. I don't know how someone's not picking them up.
So look, just caught up in a little bit of pimping shit. He is not a sex offender, people. He's a good guy.
I like how he's just like in an underage got caught up in the mix. What? Yeah. He just chucked it in there.
Very vague.
So nonchalant. Yeah. And an underage got chucked up in the mix.
Don't worry.
He was pimping, but he did not know she was underage.
And now we're here.
Right.
Yeah.
But don't worry, because they go into a little bit of detail. And
he learned to
Mighty
fight.
Mouse can explain for himself.
He learned to fight in prison for I serving out the sex offender.
He's like... a couple tattoos. Head
a few.
But what's your gist of what happened?
All right, look, man. This is 1997, all right? I'm 18 years old.
You take your pack.
I just got out of Beaumont, all right? It was a mother and her daughter. This is all public document, man. You guys want to read the court files? All you got to do is go to Prince William County, Virginia, and you can read word for word the entire court document of the whole shit. It's really easy. Nobody's hiding nothing from none of y'all.
Okay, fucking I was people 18, walking in the background
we
there.
The mother. They were dope heads. They were on heroin. We were pimping them out of a hotel room.
All right, wait on. So, his explanation, I don't know if you talked over it, but...
I did, of course.
They were dope heads. It was a mom and a daughter, and he was just pimping them, man.
Yeah. That's it.
Just pimping them.
That's it.
No pedophilia.
None.
Take it easy.
He wasn't interested in the kid.
Oh, yes, Daddy.
Right?
Right. He's a good guy, all right? Stop with the comments, YouTube.
It's such a weird situation, because, like, pedophilia, yes. And then also her mom was there.
Right.
You know,
because it's like consent.
He didn't touch anybody.
Oh, wow.
Anybody.
I didn't even think of that.
It's totally consent.
Yeah.
He didn't touch anybody.
Fireball
Jesus.
He was only the pimp.
That's it. The middleman, if you will. Facilitator, as I like to call
him. The new American hero, Mighty Man.
He was their agent.
Here I come to save the day.
Okay, I was 18. We were pimping this girl and her mother. They were dope heads. They were on heroin. We were pimping them out of a hotel room. All right? There was way more than just them, all right? And there was more than me that
thousands.
Just caught a charge. Her mother caught a charge, and a few of my homeboys caught a charge, and other dudes that I didn't even know caught a charge, all right? I didn't go to prison for this. I got probation and a fine. I didn't go to prison for this.
I got probation and a fine. It was okay.
So he was just fresh out of prison, and he was just a kid.
Yeah. Yeah,
he had to pimp him, and then he got caught up with some other bullshit.
Yeah. Like, but look, don't worry about it.
Who's really the victim here?
Right.
Mighty Mouse.
I hope this never meets the light of day so he's going to hunt us down.
Oh, he'll kill us.
He does not look like a Mighty Mouse. He looks like a fucking trained assassin. Right. That should be his name. Trained assassin. Fuck Mighty Mouse.
Mighty Mouse will join the fight.
All right, I went to prison. If you look at my record, I got 50-some felonies. You can look at my record. I got violent. I got felons. I got violent felonies.
Jesus
I got
Christ.
You know, I'm not scared of monsters.
50-something felonies.
Violent felonies are his
50-something.
Excuse.
Yeah.
That it's not
why
pedophilia.
Isn't he, wait a minute.
But 50 violent felonies are cool.
Why isn't Mighty Mouse still in jail?
Well, I mean, that's got to stand for something, though. He's telling you, hey, listen, I've done some really fucked up shit, but I did not do this.
Yeah.
It's just funny that it's like, you know, I've robbed people, I pimped people, but look, I'm not.
I draw the line at kid touching.
which is credible, but he's also throwing out shit.
He's a noble guy.
That like, no one knows.
He's incriminating himself on fucking so much shit right now.
We know that where there's danger, he is there.
He is there.
And then Scarface is just fucking nodding there like Don King. Like,
yeah, he's got his hands folded on his fucking chest. And, you know, he couldn't be happier right
Finally
now.
Finally, we this can tell our side.
Yeah, this is exactly how I wanted the Empire to go. I'm addressing kid-touching fucking allegations. We just want to fight each other in the backyard like a bunch of savages. Right. And now we have to do this.
I didn't expect Mighty Mouse to sound like that.
Yeah, no.
Well,
doesn't sound that menacing.
He grew up fighting. Because of that fucking
voice. I wouldn't
want
to run into him.
Right, no, hell no. I'm not scared of monsters, but I'm scared of monsters.
I go to bed at 9 p.m. I'm scared of Mighty Mouses.
Yeah.
We are in danger.
You're early bedder too?
Yeah.
Fuck, man. I'm in bed by 9.
Shit, I got bad knees. I'm lactose intolerant.
You got some breast milk in the back.
Breast milk?
Yes. Yeah. No, cured this guy. A beautiful mind.
A beautiful mind.
What the fuck are you talking about, man?
If you had your earphones on, you'd hear.
Hey, man. I'm starting sweating. My ears start sweating.
I thought you're never hot because you're black. You always say that every week.
I'm saying, my ears start sweating. I don't know why, so I just took them down.
It's that breast milk.
That breast milk.
Kick it in. It's supercharging his hearing now. It's going to be off the fucking charts.
Are you turning into a superhero?
He'll be flying around the studio soon.
That'd be dope. I'll be snatching up all the pussy.
It always goes back to pussy.
Superbo.
Yes.
Superbo.
Superbo. Yeah. SP on his chest.
Yeah, man.
Oh, shit.
It's a bird. It's a plane.
So his explanation is just winning me over. Dude. I'm going to invest in street beefs.
Yeah. Dude, I'm telling you, it's getting really popular.
It must be because now they're putting out fucking, like, they're getting out ahead of the curve on some of this shit.
Doing professional shit.
Yeah. Like, I mean, this was top-notch production here. The fat country bumpkins walking around in the background. I mean, you know, the traffic on Main Street USA passing by them, they're selling their story.
You have to see the fight, though, to get, like, a flavor of it. There's people standing around a backyard, and the people in the ring are punching each other in the face into the dirt. So it's,
yeah, we got to watch
tough.
Some of these street beefs videos.
But, you know.
Sounds weak.
Yeah, well, it's, you know,
I mean, I know it's nobody,
mainstream.
It's not somebody getting stuck in a fucking carpet roller and smeared to, pieces.
Accidental murder.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, we need to go to the videos and stuff like that, you know, sometime.
We will.
Know? I mean, I want to see Death, Murder, and Mayhem.
Oh, well.
I think he has a little bit more of, like, an explanation.
Yeah, we're going to figure out what he's got to say, because, I mean, this is really riveting.
Charges. I got a home invasion charge. I got a gun while being convicted of felony. I got nighttime burglaries, grand larceny.
Daytime burglaries.
My list goes on and on and on. I got a million different
Eclipse things, burglaries. Right? Sunday burglaries.
I have a million different shit. He says, like, I got a million different shit. Like, he doesn't even know.
But I did not touch the kids.
Right.
Robbed the preacher.
he's got everything else but kid touching on that resume.
Right, you know? Everything. He checks every box.
That's where he draws the line.
Yeah.
Smack my mom.
Attempted murder.
Here I come to save the day.
Non-bomb.
This was probably the weakest shit you had ever been drawing.
This ain't even
Dana White chimes in. You shit, dude. There's nothing else.
Yeah, he had probation and a fine.
Ours, man. I mean, listen. When I seen shit in prison, I'm talking about hardcore motherfuckers getting real shit done to them. You know what I'm saying?
Like, and I was the one doing it.
Done to them. This is not. This is nothing. This is absolutely nothing. And I'm not trying to downplay it because it was fucked up on my part. Just like 90% of all the other charges that I caught. Look, I didn't have no money. I didn't have
just 90. But the other 10 were, you know, personal. They
Which
had to be
is
done.
Still hundreds and hundreds of charges.
Oh, yeah.
So,
yeah. So that 10% is a fucking crime wave, right. You know, in one small town in Virginia. They were so happy when this fucking guy was incarcerated. Unfucking believable.
No, dude, he's turned his life around.
Oh, yeah. Obviously, he has.
50-something felonies.
Thank you, man. Right. 50. That
he was charged with.
Yeah. This is probably the weakest shit he's
ever
caught.
The shit he was caught.
Right. Yeah.
That's the shit they caught him for.
Yeah. How many did he fight? And you lost all of them?
Well, look.
You lost all of them? 50 fucking felonies,
When
man.
Your kids have a poster of him on their fucking wall, I'm going to tell you that Mighty Mouse is an American hero.
Oh. We'll finish up Mighty Mouse and then we're going to wrap it up. Right. Take a little break. Let the Sith Lord go.
Gotta go, baby.
It's all press for time.
Press for time, man. Gotta go make that money.
I have a leg to stand on to fight a charge. I had no lawyer. All right, so I got a prosecutor attorney. I mean, a district attorney, right. Whatever the hell they're called.
A court appointed attorney
to fight for
you. Exactly. So basically,
fucking retard.
I'm fucking taking plea bargains. I'm young.
That was the Sith who said that, by the way, Mighty Mouse.
Right.
He called you a fucking retard. I just want to clarify.
Oh, fuck him. I got something for him.
Okay.
Hey, listen.
I got something for him. Fuck all
into
that.
The mic. Into the mic.
Mighty Mouse.
Fuck all that.
Andre McSween is not with him.
Yes.
Fuck all that. Fuck all that tough talk. I got something to knock all that sleeve shit
as
right off
as far as I'm concerned.
That. Knock the skin off that.
Well,
everything you're saying right now is important.
Yeah.
As another put up or shut up, guess what, Sith? We're going to see Clay Miles down in Washington right outside Scarface's yard where they fight, and I've already pre-set up a fight between you and Mighty Mouse.
Mighty Mouse is on the way.
Talking about no fighting?
Hot lead.
Hot fucking fire for that motherfucker.
Right. Well,
you think
then maybe next time.
Kills Mighty Mouse?
No.
Look at Mighty Mouse.
Mighty Mouse eats hot lead.
Mighty Mouse has been through a lot of shit, man.
I got something for Mighty Mouse.
Uh-oh.
Believe that.
We're going to build this up as the fight of the century.
Ain't no fight.
Can we get you in shape first?
Ain't no fight.
I just want to do like
that. You're going to hear two sounds.
I want to do the Rocky training
it's
with
gonna
you.
You're going to hear bang. You're going to hear him hitting the ground.
So it's premeditated.
Oh,
look,
no.
He's all hyped up on breast milk right now, Mighty Mouse. Sorry.
We try to stop him.
Wait a minute. Yeah, I'm not going to fight that guy.
Yeah,
I would no way fuck fight him.
Why?
I wouldn't want to fight him. He just seems.
He's got tattoos.
He's too easy
on
to
top
beat.
Of tattoos.
Yes.
Yeah.
He got tattoos.
Yeah, he has like three or four fucking layers of tattoos.
He stopped giving a fuck a long time ago.
You don't even know what color he is. He's green.
Right? Exactly. Probably got his,
he's tattoo green.
Probably got his dick tattooed. Fuck out of here, man.
That's what it says right on the dick. Fuck out of here.
I am not.
He's on fire.
I'm not fucking with him, man. I have to go and get my.
He's a friend of the show. I wouldn't worry about
him.
He's loved the show ever since
he's coming on next week. He's actually going to sit in Dre's chair.
Yeah, he can sit here all he wants.
I see a felony coming up for him.
I got 51 felonies. He's caught one last week in Jamesburg.
Young, I don't know any fucking better.
18.
So,
you don't know no better.
DNA case. This is not something that, like, oh, we're going to go get DNA. No, this is basically just somebody.
I'll tell you what, the wrestling promos came a long way from when Mean Gene used to interview Hogan and shit.
Right, yeah.
These things are really fucking coming a long way.
50 felonies now. Hogan, you're nothing. Like, you just talk about eating vitamins. This guy's got felonies.
Yeah. Saying prayers and
right.
shit.
That's scaring people.
Yeah.
Come on.
Look at this. He's got the little grrr thing going right now.
The only place he doesn't have tattoos is
talking to that.
Yeah.
Talking to that.
That's
the only thing clean.
Damn.
He doesn't have any fingerprints left either.
No.
No, they're melted off.
Yes.
He's saying something and it goes along. It's called carnal knowledge. It can happen to anybody. Mike Tyson, Tupac, fucking R. Kelly, Kobe Bryant. You know what I'm saying? This is basically what Tupac even had a saying. He said, a bitch bent the truth and told a lie. There's a real lot of G's doing time.
Yep.
That was exactly one of his statements.
And that's the truth. And I don't mean to cut
it must be real.
Off, but, you know, listen,
Tupac quote.
I'll never down a rate.
Yeah, that's it, man. I believe it now. Tupac's alive.
Yeah.
Tupac's speaking to me.
Victim, but this ain't that. Okay, let's start. Like,
this isn't a violent charge.
This isn't a violent.
You and your fucking charges already. Enough. We get it with the charges.
He has to be very specific. Like, to a lot of outsiders, a charge is a charge. To him, no. There's violence and, you know, other kinds of felonies.
Yeah, it's like tier one and tier two.
He's very technical because he spends a lot of time in court. Court
right.
is very, very technical.
Yeah. Taking a lot of notes and shit, right?
Yeah, because just like in New Jersey, if I get arrested tonight, and
it's a high probability it'll happen.
If it's not a violent crime, they'll let me out the next day. There's no bail. There's no bail in New Jersey, and they're gonna let you out. Now, if I get arrested tonight and I had a fight or I was in a domestic violence, they're gonna keep me in because they're gonna think I'm a threat to society. Shit's crazy.
I think you are a threat to
society. Yeah, I was thinking
regardless.
The same thing. I mean,
I don't care what
I'm wondering
do.
If you should
you
be on a list of some sorts.
What?
Yeah, you just drive home fine. I still
just to be monitored. I'm not saying you
do
anything wrong.
I don't need to be fucking monitored.
I think
for
now's enough time to take another shot of breast milk.
Yeah. Oh, you, they're saying you got to go.
Wear it off.
They're telling us you got to go.
I mean, listen, ain't nothing wrong with me.
No. Nothing at all.
Ain't nothing wrong with me.
No.
Absolutely. There's something wrong with y'all. You guys are.
Oh, there is something wrong with me.
Yeah,
dude.
You guys.
I thought of another layer.
You guys are sensitive.
47.
I thought of another layer of the onion.
Oh, yeah?
It goes back to when I was in like second or third grade.
Oh.
Right? I remember that I used to have. The number 47 has been coming up in my mind recently. And I remember back when I was young, I used to have a strong relation to the number 47.
47 nuts.
Because out in a week. And that was the bus I took. Bus number 47.
Oh, you was in love with the bus
school.
Driver.
Absolutely.
Oh, and was Debbie?
Sharon. Frosted hair.
How old were you that you still remember your bus driver?
I was fucking I remember because it was sexual.
Yeah.
I used to have a thing. I'd go home and rub myself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
How old were you?
Like fifth grade.
Let me tell you something.
No, maybe younger. No, I was third.
Oh.
Yeah.
Total perv.
That's funny you said that.
Because you rubbed the same bus driver. Shadow? Nah. Frosted hair?
I don't know.
She's kind of thick.
Yeah. Oh, wait a minute, man. When we used to go to Voltec,
No, she didn't drive for you guys. Sorry.
Listen,
your fantasy's ruined.
Every
Sith
fucking time we got on the
totally just
Sith beat me to it.
Every time we got on this bus, the bus smelled like fucking pussy, man.
Right.
Fucking time.
Pussy and bus seats. That bus seat smell. If I smell that now, it takes me back to then. That leather smell?
Yeah,
it takes me back to when I used to like rub one out to the bus driver that I liked. But I never came. I was too young to come.
Wait, you would rub it out on the bus?
Sometimes.
Would
not
you?
Like, yeah,
on
I would just
the
rub.
Bus?
I would just rub like through my pants.
I quit this show. Innocent. You guys are insane.
I was so innocent.
It was my sweatpants. My gray sweatpants with the little elastic fucking ankles that we used to have when we were
like
kids.
Just rub it on the outside of your pants?
Yeah. I'd just sit there and rub under my book bag.
Wow. Yeah. Man. I bet you was the same bus driver, man. I never.
No, it wasn't. All right.
I bet
you. Can't have her.
I bet you. This bus, every time
we got on
there. He
was three seats fucking
there.
Behind him, fucking rubbing himself in his sweatpants. The whole fucking bus was all rubbing themselves.
But she wasn't even that hot. Like,
well,
thinking back now,
you're all a bunch of
I can still picture
weirdos,
her.
That's why.
I can still picture her, but she wasn't that hot.
No,
but she was
she
did it for me.
She did it for me, baby.
So, Sharon, if you're listening, honey.
She's dead by
thank
now,
you.
Dude.
She's probably like 70 now.
Yeah.
She might still be hot.
She's rubbing herself listening to me. Mm. The tables have turned.
Yeah.
She's
rubbing herself in her sweatpants.
Yeah.
Her fucking Depends.
Through her Depends. Yeah. Shouldn't it not be called Depends? It probably should be called It's Gonna Happen.
Fucking bus seat, like.
That's the old good old smell.
Yeah, the bus seats?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm. I bet you it was the same lady, man.
Majestic.
I swear
it's
to God.
It's not her!
It's her, man. I'm trying to tell
ruining
you.
Ruining it.
Every time we, I mean.
47.
Used to be,
you don't have 47, Sith.
It was about,
he does.
It was about 12 of us, and every time we got.
Because how come 47 keeps coming up in my life these days?
You know what?
It's time.
I got to ask
like
who's
else?
On the bus.
Got to go conquer that fucking 70-year-old bus driver. I'm sorry.
I got to find out who's on the bus with us.
The wheels. I suck.
Yeah, I wanted to go round and round.
You want to piggyback my bomb? That's good. Thank you. Get that stench off of me. Fuck that. Thank you. Sith Lord, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to take a quick break. Get you up on out of here.
I got to go, motherfuckers.
That's it.
You want to check me out? You check me out on Facebook, Dwayne Perry. You want to check me out on Snapchat? Snap them titties, Sith Lord Perry.
Snap them titties, baby.
You want to check me out? You can check me out on Live Me, Sith Lord.
Snap them titties, baby.
You want to check me out? You can check me out. Just check me out.
Just check him out and snap him them titties.
Smarter than ever.
All right. Off to the junkyard. All right, Andre McSween, how do my motherfucking people find you?
They can find me on social media, Andre McSween, on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter. I'm on all that.
There you go.
All that shit.
Okay. Any gigs you want to push? You got anything local? Fuck local. Anywhere. Where you
I'm going to be. In Twin Falls and Boise, the 15th, 16th, and 17th of November. They can check out, they can go on my social media and check out the details for that when I put them up. And I will be in Corona, Queens Mm, talking. In a week.
Wait a minute. Maybe I'll come see you.
Yeah, but that's it for right now. You know, and as the stuff comes in, they'll see it. It can go on my social media. I always post.
Right.
Always post updates.
Hey, feel free to share your shit via any of our social media fucking platforms.
Yeah.
You're hopefully going to be joining us on this crusade to save people's lives.
Well, that's what it is, man. It is a crusade.
It is a crusade. We're on a mission for your soul.
We're doing the God's work.
That's it, man. Right. The golden God's work.
That's right.
On my way. Fireball Jesus.
Mm.
Thank you, man. Thank you. What a fucking show,
my
man.
My pleasure. I
what
laughed.
What a fucking show. Laughed. I cried.
Right.
You know, I jerked off the Sith drinking breast milk.
Yeah. Some things are just going to stay with me now.
Isn't the breast milk thing? It seems like so long ago. But... Anyway. It just happened so long
ago.
For
me, it was several decades.
I don't even know. Yeah, right? Yeah. When I was five.
Months.
Oh, man. Didn't want to find you, so I'm not going to tell them I find you.
No, don't look for me, and I won't look for you. You know our deal, people.
All right. Andre, man, thank you.
Yo, thank you for having
fucking,
me, man.
Thank you, brother. You
yeah, man. Great job.
Always a great time, man, and I hope we see you again real soon.
Hell yeah, man. Hell yeah. Hopefully the people will be listening to me real soon.
Yeah. Well, listen, man. Go find him. Funny fucking guy. Great entertainer. He's a good person. He's a good person. I almost feel bad doing this in front of you sometimes. You know? And like, we still have to ride back to the train together. And I'm like, I don't know what I'm going to talk about. You know?
Yeah. You know, we still going to have shit to talk about.
Oh, absolutely. Right. Absolutely. All right, people. Check us out. DamageGoodsInc.com. And there's links to everything else we're on. Check out the rest of the shows on this network. A couple more coming soon. We're taking over. Fuck you.
Damaged Goods.